golf course lighting from LG4 sports lighting. Hi, I am Nelca and I am your book narrator for this topic, golf course lighting, derived from lighting guide for sports lighting. Golf course. While most golf course lighting is restricted to practice areas and putting greens, there is growing interest in lighting par 3 and shortened courses for night play. The principal requirement in all cases is to ensure that environmental impact is minimized while creating a pleasant nighttime appearance with good viewing conditions for golfers. Holes should be separately illuminated with floodlights located and directed so as to prevent or minimize destruction and glare to adjacent playing areas. Each hole consists of a tee, fairway, and green areas, and each may have somewhat different lighting requirements. However, the principal lighting considerations will be to enable the course features to be easily discerned, to minimize glare in the principal directions of play, to provide continuous illumination of each hole and enable golfers to assess distance, to enable the full flight of the ball to be followed and its final resting place to be easily observed, and to provide uniform illumination over putting greens and tees. The tees. These areas will require reasonable illuminance uniformity with bi-directional lighting to ensure that golfers cannot shadow the ball. Floodlight mounting heights must be lower than usually required for the fairways, since the lighting provision is generally dedicated to the tee and initial fairway area. As the speed of the ball in the initial flight zone is too high to enable the ball to be followed visually, only horizontal illuminance need to be considered. Floodlights should be located so as to minimize glare to players as they tee off. The lux level horizontal requirements for class 1 is 200 lux, for class 2 is 100 lux. The overall uniformity for both class 1 and 2 is 0.7. Bidirectional lighting to avoid shadow, dedicated lighting, low mounting height floodlights, and the glare rating is not more than 50, and the CRI is not less than 60. The fairways. Over these areas, it is important that the flight of the ball can be followed easily. Therefore, adequate vertical illuminance over the ball in the flight to a height of 20 meters is necessary. This is usually achieved via staggered lighting system along the edges of a rough on either side of the fairway. The flood lighting direction should be longitudinally down and across the fairway to minimize glare to golfers playing the hole. A reduced level of horizontal illuminance and overall uniformity is acceptable over the main fairway and semi-rough areas on either side, sufficient to allow balls to be played. It is generally accepted that balls played into the rough will only be illuminated by spill light and that their location and play may prove difficult. The lux level requirements for horizontal in class 1 is 100 lux and for class 2 is 75 lux. The overall uniformity for both class 1 and class 2 is 0.5. Lighting strategy, staggered lighting along the edges, vertical illuminance at 20 meters height, and the glare rating is not more than 50 and CRI is not less than 60. The lux level for vertical for class 1 is 200 lux and for class 2 is 150 lux. The overall uniformity for the vertical is not applicable. There are notes 1 to 4. For note 1, vertical illuminance at 5 meters above the fairway. For note 2, semi-rough ground to be included. Note 3, not applicable over water obstacles and features. And note 4, the lighting levels stated do not relate to requirements for general course maintenance. Putting green or the greens. These should be illuminated to a higher horizontal illuminance than tees or fairways to enable them to discern easily at a distance. Lighting of the green should be multi-directional as well, ensuring minimal shadowing to all areas and a high level of horizontal uniformity. Floodlight mounting height should be adequate to ensure that the ball is seen over its full pitch height onto the green while minimizing glare. To achieve this, it is also acceptable for green floodlights to be aimed in the general direction of adjacent bunkers and semi-rough areas surrounding the green. The lux level requirements for horizontal for class 1 and class 2. For class 1 is 250 lux and for class 2 is 150 lux. The overall uniformity requirements for both class 1 and class 2 is 0.7. It needs to have a multi-directional lighting to avoid shadows, high level of horizontal uniformity, and the glare rating is not more than 50 and the CRI is not less than 60. In general, holes are located over adjacent areas and are often in close proximity, separated by rough ground or landscaped features. Where possible, the floodlighting mast on the hole should be utilized to illuminate adjacent holes separately so as to minimize obstruction over the whole course. Water features like lakes deliberately placed as obstructions within the line of play need not to be separately illuminated. However, the air space above the water must be lit so as to achieve adequate vertical illuminance to allow golfers to follow the flight of the ball. Bunkers adjacent to the greens should be illuminated from the green flood lighting system and shadowing within them reduced as much as possible. However, bunkers within fairways need only receive general illumination from the main fairway flood lighting. Strong shadowing may occasionally result and should be accepted as a feature of the obstacle, unless specified otherwise by the course designers. To summarize, for class 1 and for class 2, the horizontal illuminance on tees are 200 lux, uniformity is 0.7, and for class 2 is 100 lux and the uniformity is 0.7. The horizontal illuminance on fairways with the nodes of 2 and 3, the average horizontal illuminance is 100 and the overall uniformity is 0.5, while for class 2 is 75 and the overall uniformity is 0.5. The vertical illuminance on fairways with nodes 2 and 3 again, the vertical lux level requirements is 200 lux and for class 2 is 150 lux. There is no requirements for overall uniformity for vertical illuminance. For horizontal illuminance on greens, for class 1 is 250 lux with overall uniformity is 0.7 and for class 2 is 150 lux and the overall uniformity is 0.7 as well. The glare rating for both class 1 and class 2 is 50 and the color rendering index is not less than 60 CRI. CTV Group C. For the note 1 on horizontal and vertical illuminance on the fairways, on note 1, vertical illuminance at 5 meters above the fairway. It is therefore that the 100 lux and 200 lux requirements must be in the 5 meters above the ground. For note number 2, semi-rough ground to be included. So the semi-rough ground must be included in the lighting calculation points. And for the note 3, it is not applicable over water obstacles and features. And for the note 4, the lighting levels stated here in this table do not relate to requirements for general course maintenance. Driving range. The distance markers must be clearly visible and the player must be able to follow the flight of the ball. While the tee areas will require separate illumination, there should be general illumination of the full length of the golf range surface. End range lighting systems have primarily been utilized to illuminate golf ranges. This type of system employs high-powered floodlights behind tee locations with high angles of elevation to achieve adequate vertical illumination at each target area. Mounting heights will have little significant influence above the resultant illumination of the distance markers, and as the glare to golfers will not be an influencing factor, low mounting heights may be used. Glare to the surrounding neighborhood is probable from viewing directions toward the tees in the direction of play. Natural screening or careful sighting of the golf range will provide the best practical solution to alleviate any direct glare. In instances where low obtrusive light to the surroundings is required, alternative floodlighting systems may prove to be more suitable. This primarily consists of berm, pit, and side lighting installations. Berm lighting utilizes floodlights located within the golf range surface and should achieve uniform vertical illumination of the golf balls in flight and a patterned illumination of the range surface. Direct glare at the boundary can be prevented by low screening or fencing, provided that the installation is not overlooked. Pit lighting is a variation of berm lighting, but the floodlights are mounted within shallow pits and a range surface. A mound is built in front of the floodlight and is used to provide a forward shadow zone to prevent direct glare to properties overlooking the end of range. Since recessed floodlights will not illuminate the range surface, additional general lighting is necessary from side-mounted floodlighting. Side lighting from floodlights located on columns on each side of the range should provide uniform horizontal and vertical illumination with reduced obtrusive light compared to the end range system. The main flood lighting for the driving range is unlikely to provide sufficient illumination of open tees areas. This should be separately lit from additional floodlights mounted on columns located behind the tees. Golf ranges with covered tee booths will require separate lighting with the booths, usually from fluorescent luminaires suitable for outdoor use. It may also be necessary to utilize additional low-powered floodlights mounted above the tee booths should the employed lighting system not adequately illuminate the range surface foreground area. Summary table for Class 3, which is only applicable for a driving range. For Class 3, the horizontal luminance on tees must be 100 lux and the overall uniformity is 0.8. And for the vertical illuminance on distance marker, which is 1 meter above the ground level, is 50 lux. And the overall uniformity for the vertical is not applicable. And the color rendering index must be not less than 20 CRI. Thank you for listening in this book narration. If you want to know more, join us in our free webinar about golf course lighting design techniques on September 30, 2017, 2 p.m. Dubai time or GMT plus 4. See you there. Thank you for listening. See you again later.